Hey everyone, it's Wobby time for another edition of the Pick 6. This one's a special one. I'm in the Vikings Table food truck presented by Xcel Energy. More on that in a minute. First, let's answer some of your questions. The first question comes from Adam in LA, California. Who is a truly underrated player on our team? We have a lot of star names, but not everyone can be a star. Good question, Adam. The name that pops into my mind right away, defensive tackle Shamar Stephen. The Vikings drafted Shamar in the seventh round back in 2014. He had a good first few seasons. Then he went to Seattle last year, but this year he's back on our roster, and I think he's a key cog in the middle of the Vikings defense. He can take up blockers and keep our linebackers free so they can chase and tackle. Also, Shamar has some position flexibility. He took a lot of reps at nose tackle this spring while Linval wasn't participating in all the team drills, but I think when everyone's healthy, Shamar can also play some three technique. He's gonna be a key addition to our defense. The next question comes from Jason in Melcher, Iowa. Why isn't Jayron Kearse mentioned as someone who could start at safety next to Harrison Smith? I like Anthony Harris, but this spot doesn't get mentioned as a competition much for some reason. Well, believe me, it's always a competition with Coach Zimmer. He's not handing out starting spots for charity. But you're right, Anthony Harris is considered the favorite to start in this spot. That doesn't mean Jayron Kearse won't play a bunch. I think he's gonna see significant snaps on defense this season. And it may not just be at safety. It could be at big nickel. It could be on the second level of the defense, or it could be as a third safety. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter where he plays. Jayron Kearse is gonna impact the Vikings. Next question comes from Daniel in Boston, Massachusetts. Who is winning the race for returning kicks and punts? This is gonna be a fun position battle to watch. Both kickoff returner and punt returner spots are open with Marcus Sherrill's departure this offseason. Who's winning it right now? Hard to say, but we see a lot of Amir Abdullah and Chad Beebe taking the reps in practice. We'll see if that changes during training camp. I think Holton Hill and Jordan Taylor are also options in this spot. And once healthy, Mike Hughes is a talented returner as well. Next question comes from Melvin in Apple Valley, Minnesota. We seemed a little banged up at the end of minicamp this year. Anything to be concerned about? You're right, there were some Vikings missing in action at the end of the offseason program. Irv Smith, David Morgan, Tyler Conklin, Jordan Taylor, just a few of the names who had to miss some time. But no, nothing to be worried about. That happens during the end of the offseason program. It's better to save those guys and keep them healthy so they're ready to go when training camp starts at the end of July. Speaking of training camp, Vikings training camp dates will be released this week, so stay tuned for that. Next question comes from Jim in Dodge Center. Loved seeing Steve Jordan get the Ring of Honor nod. He was a big-time playmaker back in the day. No doubt about it, Jim. Steve changed the tight end position a little bit. He was a pure pass catcher, still had toughness and could block, but a very productive pass catcher in the passing game for the Vikings. Finished his career with 25 touchdowns, most for a Vikings tight end of all time at the time of his retirement. Also remains third all-time in Vikings history with 498 catches. Congratulations to Steve on being inducted into the Ring of Honor. We were there when Viking COO Kevin Warren announced to the team that Steve Jordan was going into the Ring of Honor. For that behind-the-scenes footage, make sure you go to Vikings.com. And the final question comes from Kylie at Fresno State. I applaud the Minnesota Vikings organization. That amazing food truck, which will provide free healthy meals to children in need, is a great idea. The Minnesota Vikings are a class organization. Yeah, it is a pretty cool idea and another example of the Wilf family's philanthropic nature as stewards of the Minnesota Vikings. In case you missed it, the Minnesota Vikings Foundation, in partnership with Xcel Energy, last week introduced Vikings Table, a custom-built food truck with the mission of serving healthy meals and nutritional education to youth across the Minneapolis-St. Paul community. For more information on that, go to Vikings.com, but also when you come to training camp or to other cool events in the greater metro area, make sure you keep an eye open for the Vikings Table so you can get some awesome food from this cool food truck. That's gonna do it for this week's edition of the Pick 6. We'll be back next week with another edition, so please continue to submit your questions to the email address on the bottom of the screen, and we'll see you next week.